I would say to that, don't only question the medical practitioner, the person who has a shingle with MBBS, MD, MACP, but also question the Ayurvedic practitioner.
Everybody.
And the herbalist. Now, I see patients who develop what's called fulminant hepatic failure. They're going to die within a few days from liver failure. If you have kidney failure, you can get dialysis. If you have lung problems, severe lung problems, you can be on a ventilator till things are figured out and you can be fixed. If you have acute liver failure, you better pray that you get a transplant in time. And every single year, there are articles published in the medical literature of herbs, natural, right, part of nature, that kill people. Pulmonary hypertension, heart failure, kidney disease, acute liver failure. My patients with a variety of liver disorders, by the way, 1 billion people in the world have chronic liver disease. 1 billion people in the world have chronic liver disease. And I ask every single patient about, what do you take? And the majority of them are taking things they've never told any other physician. They're taking herbs, and I say, what are you taking? And then the list goes on and on. I say, Dr. Chopra, what do you think about that? I say, how much are you paying for that? I'm paying $342 out of pocket a month. I say, I call that a wallet biopsy. And just because it's natural doesn't mean it's safe, right? Earthquakes, Katrina, the tornadoes that are happening right now, which is why Deepak and I will not be on Piers Brosnan tonight. Tornadoes sent a gush and swept us off the show. But they're part of nature. Cobra venom is part of nature. So we have to apply the same standards as we should to Western medicine that we do to complementary or integrative medicine as well.